This is Joseph Drust, and welcome back to another episode of Ask ZBrush. So we had a question sent in asking, how can I make a chain with MicroPoly and Dynamics? So to start off, I just have ZBrush loaded up, and I just have an example file here loaded in. So the question is asking about using the Dynamics menu that is in ZBrush 2021 or higher, and create some sort of chain. So this is the chain here, and if I go to my Dynamics menu and run the simulation, I'll be able to take this and then drape it across my object here and get this result. Now, the functionality of this is a little bit of a trick. So what I have here is a very simple object, and then I have a MicroPoly applied to it that looks like a chain. So if I go to my tool palette over here and open the geometry area, and then down here in the dynamic subdivision area, you can see that I have dynamic subdivision applied. So if I turn this off and then just turn on my polyframes, you can see this is the model that I am currently deforming with the dynamics. And then what I'm doing is I'm replacing every poly on this object with a MicroPoly. And the MicroPoly here looks like this little chain link. And so now, when that model deforms, it now gets the appearance that it is a chain. So I'm going to go through the process on how to quickly generate this kind of shape here. So just quickly generating a MicroPoly, and then setting up a simple piece of geometry to apply that MicroPoly to, and then just how to use the dynamics quickly to get this to fall across the surface and give you this kind of effect. So to start, we first just need to create a MicroPoly object. And this is the object that's going to be replacing the polygon on my mesh and then give me the illusion of it looking like a chain. Now, in the example I'm going to do here, let's say you have an insert mesh curve brush that you've already been using. And so let's say I go over to the standard brush here, and in here I find the IMM curve brush, and just open this up. And then in here, there's a bunch of different curves. So let's say I like this necklace link, right? So normally with a IMM curve brush, I can go back to my model, I can click and drag, and this is going to give me a curve, and you see I'm going to get this IMM part replicated across the curve. So let's say I have a IMM curve brush that I use all the time for chains or necklaces. So I want to just take that, and I want to now be able to use that with the dynamics option inside of ZBrush to get it to flow across the surface. So I'm just going to come up here, and with the IMM curve brush selected, I'm just going to select this part. And with this part selected, what I want to do is I want to take the part and then modify it and make a new MicroPoly out of it. So I'm going to go to the tool palette over here. I'm going to click on a spot and then select, say, the Polymesh 3D star. I have that IMM curve brush selected. I have that necklace link selected. I'm going to go to geometry, modify topology, and in here there is a mesh from brush button. This is going to take the current IMM part I have selected and then generate a new subtool from it. So with that necklace link there, if I click mesh from brush, you can see this is what I'm going to get. So I'm getting the geometry that is making that IMM part. So here I have my necklace shape. Now, in order for this to work with MicroPoly, I need to make sure I have an open edge that can then weld as another poly comes in connection to it. So this part right here for the necklace link is set up as a curve brush. So it has three poly groups. So the first poly group would be the end, this would be the other end, and then this middle part would repeat as it's drawn out on a curve. So I want to remove the top poly group here and the bottom poly group. So I'm going to hold down Control and Shift and click to isolate those poly groups and then click again to hide them. And then after I have just this shape left, I'm going to go to the tool palette over here, go to geometry, and do a delete hidden. So now I'm left with just this part. The next thing I want to do is, since this part is a repeatable shape, I want to find an area that I can split it into two parts. So this line right here is pretty good. So I'm going to hold down Control and Shift to get that select rectangle brush. I'm just going to isolate one of these. So holding down Control and Shift and then holding Alt, this is just going to leave this bottom part. And then with this bottom part selected, I'm going to hit Control W on my keyboard, which is going to apply a new poly group to the masked area. And so there is no masking on this model. So when I do this, it's just going to give a new poly group to what is visible. Then I can hold Control Shift again to bring everything back. And then at this stage, I have this model split into two poly groups. So now I can go back to the tool palette over here. I can go to geometry, modify topology, and in here I can click unweld groups border. And what this is going to do, it's going to take this mesh and now unweld the border where those two polygroups are. So clicking this will now give me an edge in there. Now I can isolate one part of this. I can now hold Control and mask it, and then hold Control and Shift to bring everything back. And now that I have one part masked, unwelded, and the other part unmasked, I can now switch to the Gizmo 3D. I can click and drag and move that part upward, and then clear my mask. And now I have fixed the shape, so I have an open edge and an open edge, and this will now work as a MicroPoly. Now after I have this created, I can come down to the deformation area here. I can click Unify to make sure it is unified into that square format. I also want to rotate this shape so that it goes horizontally across the cam view icon here. And this is just the alignment you need in order to set up a MicroPoly. So I'm going to go to Move Scale or Rotate. I'm going to center the Gizmo 3D there. I'm going to click and drag and hold down Shift to align it to 90 degrees. And then now this part is good to go for MicroPoly. So then I go back up to the tool palette and I'm going to save this out. And when I save it, I want to put it in the MicroPoly folder that is inside of ZBrush. So I'm going to click Save As and then navigate to my Pixelogic ZBrush 2021 folder. And then in here, there is a Z MicroPoly folder. I'm going to open that up. And then in here, I'm going to save this tool out. So I'm going to save this as Necklace Link and then click Save. So now I've modified an existing IMM brush that I was using for generating necklace links. I've now turned this into an object that can be used now for MicroPoly. So now that I have my MicroPoly set, I now just need to create my tool that I'm going to use with the dynamics to apply that MicroPoly to and then also have it deform. So I'm going to go back to my tool palette over here, and then I'm just going to select a plain 3D object. Now for a necklace, one way you can kind of generate it is if it's just a long chain. So that's what we're going to do here. So with my plain 3D object, I'm going to go to the tool palette, go down to the initialize area here. In here, I want to change my horizontal divide. So right now it has 33 divisions. So I want to change this down to say 1. And then now I want to change the horizontal radius as well and just shrink this down. And what I'm doing here is I'm going through and I'm changing the shape so that these polys on the strip here are square. Now, they don't have to be perfectly square, but you want them pretty close because the MicroPoly is going to come through and it's going to replace every one of those polygons. And if those polygons contain any distortion, then it's going to distort our MicroPoly. So you want to kind of keep them as square as possible. Now, after I have my plain 3D object initialized, so those settings are changed there, I can now go to the tool palette and click Make Poly Mesh 3D, and now I have my simple poly object. So now that I have my strip here, I can now go to the tool geometry dynamics area. I can activate dynamics. I'm going to turn these smooth subdivisions down to 0, and then I'm going to turn MicroPoly on. And then in here now, since we saved that MicroPoly to that MicroPoly folder, we should now be able to locate our necklace link MicroPoly. So here we have it here. I can now click that. And then when you click that, if I turn off my polyframes, you can see that it's now being applied across that strip of polygons. If I turn dynamic off, this was my mesh that I created. And then with dynamic on, it's now looking like that necklace link. So now I can take this tool and we can go back to our original object here that had that kind of mandrel shape. I'm just going to undo this to get back to there and turn off my initial chain. And now I want to append in that plain 3D object that I just created and applied the MicroPoly to. So I'm just going to rename this quick so I know which one it is easily. So tool, subtool, rename. I'm going to change this to chain link. And then now I'm going to go back to the mandrel object here. I'm going to click append and I'm going to append in that chain link tool that we just created. It's going to come in like so. I can now grab that chain link, rotate it, and then maybe rotate it this way some too. I can scale this up, get it a little bit larger, so I have something like this. And now that I have this generated, I can now apply the dynamics to drive this subtool. So I'm going to the dynamics palette up here. I'm going to click this little icon, which is going to dock it to the side. In here, I'm going to make sure I have gravity turned on. I'm also going to set my floor collision. If I want the chain not to bend as much, I can increase the firmness slider here. I can also increase the self-collision if needed. And then for the collision volume, I just want to click recalculate to make sure that the subtool that is visible that is not the selected one, which is the mandrel, is the one that is going to be used for calculation. And then I've just increased my inflate a little bit so that this MicroPoly object just sits on the surface. After this is done, I can click run simulation and you see it's going to fall and then it's going to now be deformed using those dynamics. And now I have that chain link going across that object. Now, after you have this model set up, you can also use any of the cloth brushes inside of ZBrush. So I can use the cloth hook here and I can actually position this object around as well and move it around. You can also use things like the transpose cloth tool, and this will allow you to also come through and deform your object using the dynamics and that transpose cloth tool. So a lot of different things you can do now with this object. And then if at any point you find that, hey, maybe I don't want the link to look like this, I can go back to the tool palette, go down to the geometry area, go to that dynamic menu, and I can just quickly change the MicroPoly that's applied. I can come over here and just select a new MicroPoly to see what that looks like. So I can change this to say a link. I can also say maybe change it to that armor plate or maybe something even like the chain link here. And all these are still just going to be applied as a MicroPoly. So I'll be able to drag this around using this transpose cloth brush to get different results. So that is the quick rundown on how you can take an existing IMM tool and then convert it to a MicroPoly and then use it with the dynamics inside of ZBrush to have that surface deform on your models. So if you have any other questions related to ZBrush pipelines or processes, please use the hashtag AskZBrush on Twitter. Happy ZBrushing!